bless you.
Thank you very much, Mchungaji, and thank you for the opportunity to just worship with you today. Thank you for the opportunity to talk about KSEF. And yes, those are good memories. The last time I met Mchungaji last was he was preaching at Thanksgiving and prayer service at Moi High School, Kabarak, where my daughter goes. And that was a blessing. Amen. My name, as he said, is Matthew Tonga. I love the Lord Jesus Christ as my personal Lord and Savior. I became a Christian in Form 4, as a Form 4 student in Machakos High School. Then I grew up through the Christian Union in Thika High School, went to university where I was a Christian leader, and joined the what the students will call the world, you know, in the day-to-day running of life. But one of the things that has helped me to stand today is the foundation that was laid in my Christian life as a high school student by ministers who would come from various places, and during the conferences and the camps and the Sunday services and the rallies to come and encourage us. Now, those are called associates. Those are adults, older people, who have a heart for the young people. KSEF is that ministry that galvanizes Christian unions in high schools all over Kenya. It was registered in the year 1959. It was started by high school teachers who had a concern for the Christian growth and Christian ministry of high school students. And it has grown now, covers many, many parts of Kenya. But we are not able to cover all the schools in Kenya because of course, sometimes lack of capacity. And this week is a week to sensitize the church. Because KSEF does the work of the church. Actually, KSEF is an arm of the church. And this church, thankfully, is a partner with KSEF, and we thank God for that. So, as an individual, we are asking you to think and consider to get involved with high school students. Many of you became Christians in high school, if we could do a census. Many of you looking at me this morning have boys and girls who are in high school. KSEF does take care of their Sunday services. This morning, your child, your son, your daughter is sitting in a school, in a Christian Union service, listening to the word of God by a preacher who didn't come and sit in church today. I was saying in the first service that many of you have sat in church here for many years, which is good, and you have grown under the ministry of the leadership of this church. The least kind of certificate you can receive is maybe a degree in theology. Not being in a Bible school, but you have sat here. Come out with that which you have received. They tell us that there's a sea called, what is it called? Is it Red Sea, which is dead because all it does is receive? It's a Dead Sea? Dead Sea. All it does is receive. Step out, come out. We have a table outside, outside the compound, in the compound. Come talk to us. Find us how you can get involved. But I will just mention to you how you can get involved in brief. You can get involved in four ways. You can join a KSEF team. There's a team in Nairobi called KSEF Nairobi team. We will tell you about it when you come. You can get involved by what we call groaning. As you pray in your private time, here in church, wherever, remember students, high school students. Kenya will break or stand in future. Not by me. Not by Reverend Dr. Mwalo. We have kind of like lived our lives. Kenya will stand or fall in future, depending on whether our young people are living in God or we have let them go. And there's a competition. I'm not preaching. There is a great competition between the word of God for the young people. And today, the world is just, as I sat in his office this morning, he was telling me there's a competition because today it is a global village. Social media. My son is the one who sets up my phone. He is 10. Sometimes I'm not able to set up Google Map. He is the one who sets it up for me. There's competition. So there is all the pornography, all in all these things. But if we guide them to follow Christ, then our future is secure. And the church has a future. Even not. When we were in Hawaii, Reverend Mwala, I don't know if I told you this. We were sent to various churches just to visit. I went to one, I can't remember the name. And the young people of the church were my age. I'm over 50. The young people we found were old people. Those were the youngest. And like a sanctuary like this, probably they were maybe just about this. Let's pray that Kenya will never reach there. How do we do it? By praying for the young people. By going, come, we will show you how to go. I was saying in the other service today, I was like supposed to be at them Burubul Girls, but I had to come here. Come. When you go to these students, all you need is to share your testimony. You don't have to preach if you're not a preacher. I am one. All you need to say is, I got born again as a Christian, as a school, high school student, or even if it's not, I am a policewoman, or I am an accountant, or I am a lawyer, and the Lord has worked with me through this. It is possible with you by going, by giving. This is the last one. I was saying in the other service, and I was telling the men of my church, I worship at Seaton Valley Road, I was telling them, God's money is in people's pockets. Now, those were men, you know, men have wallets. I was talking to men. I said, God's money is in men's pockets. Now, God's money is in people's pockets, wallets, and handbags. Spare a bit of it over and above your tithe and give it to the work of KSEF. Come, we can show you how to do it. And you don't have to give much. It's probably 500 a month or 10,000 a year. And the work of God will grow. And our future, the future of our nation, the future of the church will be secure. God bless you and thank you for the opportunity. Amen.